Now this is the example of one more example of Dijkstra algorithm. Actually, we have I've taken the same example, but I'm trying to explain this example with the help of this algorithm. Okay, in this algorithm, you can see there are 8 steps. Step number 1, step number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now, in this Dijkstra algorithm, step number 1 says initialize single source in the graph G. This is the graph G. And this is the source vertex, correct? Now, what does it mean? It means that in this graph, we are going to initialize a single source, which is going to make for every vertex, we are going to maintain two values. One is the parent value and second one is the key value. Okay, so for example, here for this vertex S, we are going to have key value, we are going to have a parent value. Okay, then again, we are going to have key, we are going to find what is the parent. We are going to find what is the key, what is the parent. What is a key? What is a parent? Again, here also, what is a key and what is a parent? Now, when I'm saying initialize single source, what does it mean? It means for every vertex, we are going to make the key value as infinity, which is a very, very large number. Okay, so the key value will be infinity for every vertex and the parent for every vertex will be nil. Here also, parent for every vertex will be nil. Here also parent for every vertex will be nil. So for every vertex we are going to have parent as nil and the key value as infinity. Then in the second step we are going to take S is equal to 5. Now this S is representing a set. We are going to maintain a set for the vertices which we have already relaxed. Now in this third line we are creating a priority queue, or you can say a min heap. We are creating a min heap. Now in this min heap, when I'm saying G is a graph and for the vertices, okay, now when we did initialize single source, for the initialize single source, if we passed the source value as S, it means that for this source vertex we are going to make the key value as 0 and the parent is again nil, because then the parent is not applicable for this. Initialize single source means start, the key value for the start vertex is infinity and for all the other vertices the key value will be, so start key value for the start vertex will be 0 and for the all other vertices the key value will be infinity. Now when we make a min heap with this step number 3, so step number 3 is saying that create a min heap. So how does that min heap look like? This min heap will look something like this. We are going to have the start vertex S in the root because its key value is 0 and for all other vertices they will be in the child nodes. Like for example, the vertex T can be here because it is having key value as infinity. Vertex Y can be here because it is having the key value as infinity. Then we have vertex X and we have vertex Z. Okay, where the key values are infinity. Then while this min heap is not empty, this is saying, this line is saying, while the min heap is not empty, extract the minimum value. Now you can see what is extract, what is the minimum value here. This is the minimum value. So the root vertex, in case of min heap, the root vertex always contain the minimum value. So this is containing the minimum value. So we are going to extract the minimum value and we are going to store that minimum value into this U. So U is something which is storing what is the vertex which is having the minimum value and what is that minimum value. Then we are going to add this into the set, solution set, I mean the set which already, which is maintaining that these vertices we have already taken. So it is saying in this set we are maintaining that this S is source vertex is there. Okay, now for every vertex V which is adjacent to this vertex U, the for every vertex which is adjacent to this vertex S, what are the vertices which is adjacent to S? The vertices are this vertex T and the vertex Y. There are only two vertices which are adjacent to the vertex S. For every vertex which is adjacent to S, relax the weights. So relaxing means we are going to find out this distance. We are going to say if this distance is less than this key value, then we are going to update it. Again, if this distance is less than the key value, then we are going to update it. Now you see here, if you relax these two edges for this vertex S, then this key value will become 10 and here the key value will become 5, that you can see in this diagram. Now here you can see we have relaxed both the outgoing edges of this vertex S. Okay, now obviously when you're going to relax it, because we have done an extract minimum operation, so this vertex will come out of this. Now these values will change, because these values is now updated to 10 and 5. So you can see here these values are updated to 10 and 5. So how does the min heap look like? The min heap will be having y comma 5 in the root, and then we'll be having t comma 10, and then we'll be having the vertices, which is x comma infinity, and we are going to have the vertex, which is z comma infinity. After this, again we go to the while loop, and we are going to see whether the min heap is empty or not. No, min heap is not empty. Again, we are going to extract the minimum value, and this minimum value is y comma 5. So that means we are going to relax all the outgoing edges of y. So the outgoing edges of y are this, this, and this. We are going to relax these three outgoing edges. Now you understand, if you take from s to t, the already known distance was 10, because if you directly go from s to t, the already known distance is 10, but if you relax it, then the path will become 5 plus 3, which is equal to 8, and 8 is less than 10. So we updated this value. In the same way, for x, the already known distance was infinity, but because we found a path from here to here, so the total distance will become 5 plus 9, which is equal to 14. Now, in the same way, for vertex z, we relax 5 plus 2, which is going to become 7, so which is less than the previous known value, which is previously known infinite value. Okay, now after this, we have relaxed the vertex x, we have relaxed the vertex y. Now we have three vertices that are yet to be relaxed, which are t, x, and z. The min heap will contain these three vertices, where z will be in the root node, because that is containing the minimum value, which is 7, and then we'll be having t, and then we'll be having x. See guys, I'm not exactly drawing the min heap, I'm just trying to focus on the root value, because that will be more comfortable or more easier to understand. Okay, now again, if you go to the while loop, now this time z will be extracted and z will be relaxed. So you can see the vertex number z, it is relaxed, and all the outgoing edges of z, they are relaxed. But you see, this is one outgoing edge of z, and this is the second outgoing edge from z. But if you relax this value, then we found the new value as 7, which is not less than 0. So there's no benefit of relaxing this edge. But if you relax this edge, you'll see previously known value was 14, but now this 14 was updated to 13, because if you follow this path, which is 5 plus 2 plus 6, the total distance will become 13, correct? Now, in the same way, after this, we have relaxed these vertices, and we have two vertices which are left. So the min heap for these vertices will look something like this, t comma 8, and second edge x will be x comma 13, and t is the minimum value. So we are going to relax all the outgoing edges of t. So there's only one outgoing edge here, and the second outgoing edge is here, but there's no benefit of relaxing this edge, because already known distance is less, so there's no benefit of this. So we are going to relax this edge, correct? Now, in the last, we are going to relax this vertex. So this is how this algorithm is working. But there are some cases, few cases, where this algorithm will end up in an endless loop, or you can say in an infinite loop. We'll take those examples in the next video. Now, this video is, again, I've repeated the same example which I've taken the previous video, but I've just tried to make it more understandable format. Okay, let me take one more example of this Dijkstra algorithm, and I'll try to explain you how this Dijkstra algorithm fails in certain situations. Okay.